I wish I could say it was some kind of aha moment, I guess Oprah would call it, but it's not really what happened. It was just sort of an idea that I always had. I always liked the idea of starting my own business. I never really knew if it would happen or if it did, how it would happen. And then all of a sudden these pieces just kind of started falling into place. I had a now current client approach me to do some work with them. And then it kind of grew out of that. I really enjoyed working with them freelance, and I was still working at a full-time job when I was working with them. And then you know, I really loved it, and I thought, hey, you know, I think I can make a go of this. And the timing just felt right. I was ready for a new challenge. A few other pieces started to fall into place, and I just felt really good about it. And that's how I got where I am today. So I love reading magazines, I love going online, I love anything from art to fashion design to different pieces of writing. I love that stuff, I love the media. So just the creativity, I think, of other people and seeing what they can do is what challenges me to be creative and see what I can do. And I think also the success of other people and seeing what they've been able to do in their lives and their careers, I think that really drives me. I think, you know, if I can see that other people are capable of something, it sort of, it gives me the confidence of knowing that if they can do it, I can too. Challenges are many. Definitely one big challenge is obviously just finding the time to do everything. When you own your own business, you don't have the luxury of having a staff that you can delegate to. So really, for almost the first year of my business, it was pretty much all me. It was me doing the bookkeeping and the business development and the website and social media, and then of course doing all of the work that our clients were paying us for. So that was a huge challenge. I'm fortunate enough to have a couple of people working beside me now, so that's helped a lot. And then aside from that, just honestly having the confidence and the faith in knowing that you can succeed and that you can make a go of it, and just staying positive. There's definitely those days where you might not feel as good about things as you'd like to, and I think you just have to have the perseverance to stick in there and stick with it, and just know that everything's going to work out. Well, I think the first thing is just knowing that I am working with people that I love to work with, and I'm doing work that I really love to do. One of the most important things about me and having my own company is I only want to work with clients that I love to work with, people that are genuinely good people that are fun to work with, that are open to ideas, that can learn from me as much as I can learn with them. Aside from that, the rewarding thing for me is just seeing when I get some results and seeing their businesses succeed because of that. That's a really important part of business for me. I'm very results oriented, so you know, seeing a client on the front page of the Vancouver Sun or on the CTV morning live show or anything like that, it makes my heart sing. Hard because I feel like I'm still waiting for that like one amazing moment that kind of stands above and beyond all else. I think you know, I've had a lot of really great moments. You know, certainly there was a day with Vancouver Home and Design Show last fall where I had the client on all three major morning shows all in the same hour. So they were on Global, they were on CTV, and then they were also on Breakfast Television. So that was really cool, knowing that we were kind of dominating the airwaves at that point in time. You know, there was also a day last fall where one of my other clients, Earls, they were in the Vancouver Sun, Vitamin Daily, and in a couple of blogs all on the same day. So that's a pretty good thing to wake up to in the morning, is knowing to a big huge event and unloading everything and getting, you know, everything messed up in the process. It's not a glamorous job. It's not about that. It's about, you know, being creative and working with amazing people and getting results. So I'd say doing that would be job number one. Job number two, I think, would be just the willingness to do anything, the willingness to do the grunt work, to do the hard work, to do the work that probably not a lot of people want to do, because that's what will take them far. I know when I started out, there were a lot of sort of more menial tasks that I had to do that I didn't necessarily enjoy doing, but I did them to the best of my ability. And that ability to take those really rote tasks and do a good job with them and impress people is really part of what I think got me where I am today. And then aside from that, just being confident and knowing what you're worth and being comfortable talking about your strengths and really selling yourself is an important thing. I think I would tell myself that everything would work out in the end. I think at that age, like a lot of 21-year-olds, there's just so much uncertainty and you don't really know where you're going, you don't really know what you want to do with yourself. It's very hard to envision 5 or 10 years down the road, and I think if I had the ability to just have faith that everything would work out and just roll with the punches then that I do now, I think I probably would have made things a lot easier on myself. So I just tell myself to believe in myself and not to give up and